A street preacher was boldly proclaiming the gospel at a college campus. He was talking about sin, heaven, hell, and repentance. As he lovingly and passionately warned the college students about the eternal consequences of hell, a college student began to raise his voice against the street preacher. "I'm a Christian," the college student announced, "and what this man is doing is unloving. Jesus accepts you and loves you, and I'm sorry that this man is giving Christians such a bad name." Just then, another college student, an atheist, spoke up. The atheist asked the student, "Does the Bible teach that there's a hell?" The student paused for a moment and then answered with a stutter, "Yes, the Bible teaches there's a hell." The atheist replied, "I've seen you on campus almost every week for the past year. You say you believe in hell, yet not once have you ever warned me about it. I can only conclude one of two things. Either you don't really care about me, or you don't really believe the Bible." The truth is this: we need to begin living and preaching repentance again. We need to live in repentance because God has called us to be holy. Work at living in peace with everyone, and work at living a holy life, for those who are not holy will not see the Lord. That's Hebrews chapter 12, verse 14. Prove by the way you live that you have repented of your sins and turned to God. That's Matthew chapter 3, verse 8. Repentance is the turning away from sin that comes about as the result of a changed mind. Far too many believers are stuck in sin because they imagine that repentance is simply feeling bad about wrongdoing. But to repent is to say, "God, I agree with you that this is wrong. I agree with you that it needs to be removed from my life permanently in every way. I will not return to it. I will not allow my flesh to try to keep it in any small portions. I will cooperate with you in removing this from my life for the rest of my life." To repent is to recognize that you'll have to say no to what you desire. To repent is to acknowledge that at no point in the future should you allow yourself even a taste of what you sinfully desire. To repent is to set aside whatever excuses you may have made for your wrongdoing. To repent is to walk in holiness by the grace of the Holy Spirit. And once we begin living it, we must preach it, and boldly so. When the church is pure, the church is powerful. When the church is powerful, true and lasting transformation is brought about in the world. I know it's not popular to preach against sin. I know the trends of the day demand that we avoid the truths of the cross, the blood of Jesus, the evil of sin, and God's ability to transform. But if we, the church, don't preach the gospel, nobody will. If we don't warn the world about the consequences of its wickedness, nobody will. In the book of Acts, we see that Peter preached repentance as a part of the New Testament message. But God was fulfilling what all the prophets have foretold about the Messiah, that he must suffer these things. Now, repent of your sins and turn to God so that your sins may be wiped away. That's Acts chapter 3, verses 18 and 19. We see a similar message again in Acts chapter 17, verse 30. God overlooked people's ignorance about these things in earlier times, but now he commands everyone everywhere to repent of their sins and turn to him. We're so afraid of turning people off from the gospel that we try to modify the message as if God didn't get it right the first time. But understand this: it's not our preaching of truth and repentance that turns people away from the gospel. It's their desire for sin. And the judgment is based on this fact: God's light came into the world, but people loved the darkness more than the light, for their actions were evil. All who do evil hate the light and refuse to go near it for fear that their sins will be exposed. That's John chapter 3, verses 19 through 20. Clearly, we are to both live and preach repentance. If you live repentance but don't preach it, you're being selfish. If you preach repentance but don't live it, you're being a hypocrite. If you both live and preach repentance, you are being obedient to God. I'm David Diga Hernandez, and that is your Moment of Truth. Thank you for watching Encounter TV. Don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell. Also, help us spread the gospel of Jesus Christ in the power of the Holy Spirit. Make a one-time donation or become a monthly supporter by clicking on the donate link now.